Back in London, chaos was tamer but real. Europe's busiest airport reported only minimal disruption once contingency plans kicked in. But even Heathrow had its pain. About 20 weekend flights were scrubbed, and most others limped along hours late. Berlin's terminals were crowded with marathon runners and stranded flyers alike, all watching their departure times creep into the night. Even Dublin felt a ripple, telling travelers, manual check-in in place, minimal impact. Travelers were blindsided. Automated kiosks froze. At Heathrow's Terminal 4, Maria Casey watched flight after flight vanish from the screens.
They had to write our baggage tags by hand. Only two desks were open, which is why we were cheesed off.
The world saw an outage, but no one saw him. The twist shocked everyone. Watch the full episode and uncover what really happened that night at the airport. This story is inspired by real events that shook the world of aviation and cybersecurity. But the characters you meet, their choices, their secrets are purely fictional. Any resemblance to real people or organizations is purely coincidental. What you're about to hear is a reconstruction, part truth, part imagination, all meant to remind us how fragile our connected world truly is. It's 10 p.m. on 19th of September. Heathrow's glowing check-in halls are eerily quiet. A lone business traveler, Jake Anders, slides toward the gate with the biggest deal of his life on the line. He grips his boarding pass. Outside, a storm brews, not of clouds, but of bits and electrons. Somewhere in the shadows, a hidden intruder is waking up. You're tuned into Decoding Cybersecurity. I'm your host, Rakesh Nayam, taking you inside Europe's latest airport cyberattack. Chapter 1, The Midnight Flight, When the Screens Went Dark. At Heathrow on Friday night, everything seems normal. Jake breezes through electronic check-in, or so he thinks. Behind him, check-in kiosks suddenly glitch. A red warning flashes on a display. Agents stare at frozen screens. It wasn't an accident. By dawn, officials confirmed, there was a cyber attack on Friday night, 19th September. Targeting the check-in systems at major airports. In Brussels, Berlin's new Brandenburg Airport and London's Heathrow, the same failure repeated. Computers dead, forcing staff to revert to pen and paper. Travelers were blindsided. Automated kiosks froze. At Heathrow's Terminal 4, Maria Casey watched flight after flight vanish from the screens.
They had to write our baggage tags by hand. Only two desks were open, which is why we were cheesed off.
Outside the hall, chaos grew. Word spread that it wasn't just Heathrow. Berlin's grand new terminal and even Brussels were hit. Flights stalled, gates filled with confused faces. For one anxious traveler, the stakes were personal. He was bound for San Francisco at dawn, about to sign the deal of his life. His dream flight was becoming a nightmare. Trivia challenge, which of these real-world incidents was caused by a supply chain cyber attack? A, SolarWinds Orion breach, B, WannaCry, C, Stuxnet, D, NotPetya. We'll reveal the answer later in the episode, so stay tuned. Chapter 2, Supply Chain Shadows, the Invisible Breach. Investigators raced to trace the breach. Soon it became clear. This was no random glitch, but a deliberate strike at Collins Aerospace, the company behind the affected check-in software. Collins' Muse system, which links airlines to boarding gates, was breached. The hackers had slipped in through a backdoor. How? While details are still secret, the patterns are chillingly familiar. A phishing email or stolen login may have opened the door. Once inside Collins' network, the intruder moved like a ghost. They performed reconnaissance on servers and credentials, escalated privileges, and connected to a hidden command and control server abroad. Some clues even point to a rushed multi-factor bypass. as if someone tricked an admin into approving a login. Then came the payload, malware known as Heartbeat. ENISA, the European Union Agency for Cybersecurity, later confirmed it was a ransomware attack. Heartbeat quietly encrypted hundreds of workstations on Collins's LAN. The screen Jake saw, system error, was the first outward sign. Unlike flashy ransomware that shows demands, Heartbeat is stealthy. It scrambles the data without announcing itself on victim websites. No ransom note popped up on screen, just silent, total paralysis. Cyber experts call this a classic supply chain attack. As Checkpoint's Charlotte Wilson warned, these attacks often strike through the supply chain. When one vendor is compromised, the ripple effect can be immediate and far-reaching. In plain terms, hack one company's software, and all its customers feel the shock. By midnight, the damage was spreading. Check-in desks in cities Jake had never heard of were failing. Inside Collins' network, administrators scrambled, but too late. Heartbeat re-encrypted machines again and again, even after cleanup attempts. On servers, exfiltration scripts were caught trying to upload snippet files to the attacker's remote vault. In short order, the hackers had locked out airline staff and hijacked the passenger processing pipeline. Chapter 3, The Blackout, the day Europe stopped flying. By Saturday, hundreds of flights were delayed or cancelled. In Brussels, one of the worst hit hubs, authorities even cancelled half of Monday's departures. Inside Brussels airport, agents resorted to tablet computers and paper to check in each traveler by hand. A surreal blast from the past. It was like the early decades of air travel. The boarding passes were all handwritten, one passenger would later say, shaking his head. Back in London, chaos was tamer but real. Europe's busiest airport reported only minimal disruption once contingency plans kicked in. But even Heathrow had its pain. About 20 weekend flights were scrubbed, and most others limped along hours late. Berlin's terminals were crowded with marathon runners and stranded flyers alike, all watching their departure times creep into the night. Even Dublin felt the ripple, telling travelers, manual check-in in place, minimal impact. Emotions ran high. Travelers split between frustration and disbelief. A business father at Heathrow clutched his phone, voice cracking.
My daughter's wedding is in 2 days in San Francisco. I needed that flight. Now I'm stuck here while someone out there thinks this is a game.
Every canceled flight was money lost and trust eroded. Airlines scrambled to inform customers. Check your flight status, they pleaded in announcements. Behind the scenes, stock tickers and news feeds blared warnings that something had gone badly wrong in the sky. Chapter 4, The Forensics, from Heathrow to the Hacker. While airports limped along, cybercrime units sprang into action. Logs and packets were combed with atomic precision. Analysts in London pored over flight check-in records and network traces. The goal? Find the patient zero of the outbreak. Working around the clock, the National Crime Agency, NCA, and European partners pieced together the timeline. Early clues came from Collins itself. A cyber-related disruption had been noted on September 20 at select airports including London, Berlin, and Brussels. The software vendor's own network logs revealed the first signatures of Heartbeat's encryption late on the 19th. Slowly, a suspect emerged from the data. On Tuesday, UK police announced a breakthrough. A 40-year-old man in West Sussex had been arrested in connection with the incident. Officers held him on suspicion of computer misuse. They'd found his digital fingerprints inside Collins's system, and flight records placed him at Heathrow's check-in desks on that fateful night. The news stunned everyone. It was the business traveler, Jake, on whom we rode in, Jake Anders, the soft-spoken consultant, was no innocent bystander. In fact, he fit the profile in chilling ways. He had worked in tech consulting for years, including support contracts at Collins. His credentials gave him access that investigators would later cite as key. The arrestee's own travel itinerary, Heathrow to LAX, had been booked in advance. He had positioned himself perfectly to slip away after the attack. In public, authorities kept details close. The NCA deputy director called the arrest a positive step, but warned the probe was only beginning. For their part, airlines quietly breathed relief that the culprit was in custody, even as questions buzzed about the motive. Chapter 5, The Unmasking, A Face in the Crowd. And now the twist no one saw coming, the victim was the villain. On board that midnight flight to California, Jake Anders let the cabin lights dim. He felt the weight of exhaustion and relief. He'd done what no one else expected. He was the one who climbed the supply chain. Thanks to his insider knowledge, the plan unfolded like clockwork. By manipulating system logs and rerouting blame through a series of proxy servers, he had hidden in plain sight. Everyone at Collins assumed their own DevOps had been hacked. Only the skilled cyber sleuths of the NCA, combined with international partners, saw the pattern lead to him. Trivia answer, we have asked which of these real-world incidents was caused by a supply chain cyber attack. A. SolarWinds Orion breach. B. WannaCry. C. Stuxnet. D. NotPetya. And the correct answer is A. SolarWinds Orion breach. Like SolarWinds, this airport hack showed how a single compromised vendor can paralyze entire systems, from airports to airlines. At the US border, authorities finally closed in. Customs agents were handed a warrant as he stepped off the plane. In a sterile interrogation room, Jake sat across from stern-faced investigators. For a moment, he was just another suspect. Then, under relentless questioning, he broke his silence.
I never asked to be a villain, but they gave me no choice. They built this world of schedules and profits, and I was left standing on the sidelines. I had a family who needed me, bills piling up. When I realized nobody would see my face in the security camera, it felt possible.
The twist hit hard. Jake, the ordinary executive with airline tickets and spreadsheets, had orchestrated the attack from the inside. Chapter 6, Cyber Pro Breakdown, Lessons from the Runway Breach. In the end, the Heathrow cyber attack left us with a brutal lesson. Defenders must harden every link in the chain. Here's a quick checklist for cybersecurity pros. Monitor unusual outbound data flows. Watch for data being hidden inside network chatter or sudden unexplained uploads. Vet third-party software and services thoroughly. Treat every vendor as a potential weak point. Isolate critical functions so one breach can't cascade. Enforce strong authentication. Use multi-factor authentication and watch out for MFA fatigue or bypass tricks. If someone approves an unexpected login request, question it. Segment and contain your networks. Don't let one infection spread unchecked. Build firewalls between departments, like check-in systems versus flight systems, so a breach in one zone triggers alarms in another. Keep offline immutable backups. If ransomware hits, you must restore data without paying ransom and test those backups regularly. Run incident response drills. Practice hunting for threats with purple team exercises. Have your blue team ready to isolate impacts and partners, legal, PR, regulators on speed dial. Stay updated on threat intel. Hardbit is basic ransomware, but affiliates can get creative. Know the latest tactics, zero-day exploits, credential stuffing, C2 beaconing, and configure detection tools accordingly. The best defense is preparation. if your team had kept an eye on Collins Aerospace's network traffic or forced segmented logins for their critical systems, this kind of mass disruption might have been stopped in its tracks. That's our story for today's episode of Decoding Cybersecurity. I'm Rakesh Nayam. Stay vigilant out there. If you found this investigation eye-opening, hit subscribe and ring the bell so you don't miss our next episode. Check out our playlist of cybercrime deep dives for more real-world lessons. Until next time, remember, in cybersecurity, the smallest hole can sink the biggest ship. This isn't just a story about what happened. It's a warning about what can happen.